You should already know that. I should already know that. That I, mentally, I'm ready for a fight, and I'm ready for combat, and I'm ready for anything that, that is brought up on Saturday night. I shouldn't have to say cartoonish things to convince you. But hey, man, it's the culture, and I guess I've noticed that. And, but I'm getting used to it, and it is what it is. But like, I guess I don't mind it. But it's definitely I'm getting used to it.
Is it different? Obviously, you come from boxing culture. You guys are a little more polished. You've been through this. But is it different going against the MMA culture? Like, you know, talking to MMA guys.
It's different in that. Well, one thing, I don't know if Artem's ever been part of press conferences to this degree, you know, because he doesn't know how to handle himself. Like, both times I've had a press conference with him, he got up, he said nothing, then I got up there and he kept talking, you know what I'm saying? So, like, you know, and I get it, sometimes you want to have rebuttals here and there, but he didn't have a word to say every time, and then every time he wouldn't let, every time I got up there, he wouldn't let me speak, you know, he always had something to say. So I mean, I've been through this, I kind of know how it goes. I don't think Artem, I think for Artem, this is all new to him. This is the biggest fight of his career, it's the biggest money fight of his career, and you see what he said. I want the money. He said, I need the money. You see what he said. So at the end of the day, the truth came out when we were stressing each other face to face. But ultimately, I don't know. It's a press conference. I've been to many of them, you know.
Paul, you've been a showman from the beginning of your career. You were flashy, flamboyant. Then you tuned it down. You became the best boxing analyst on Showtime. Now you reverted back to the old Paulie Malignaggi. Are you that angry at him and dislike towards him that you went back to the old Paulie Malignaggi?
I'm a guy who wears my heart on my sleeve. You know, I'm somebody. I will show you who I am, and I don't need to hide it. You know, and so in that way, if I have a dislike for you, I don't know how to be fake towards you, and if I have a liking for you, I don't know how to be fake towards you. You know, like, I'm usually a polite guy. I think most people that meet me, and even have come up to me for autographs, have come up and met me. I'm not typically rude to most people, you know what I'm saying? When I meet them, when I talk to them, sometimes I may be in a rush, but other than that, I'm not typically rude, you know? So I think people that have met me would testify to this, you know? But ultimately, like I said, you can't take my kindness for weakness either, you know? Like, if you come at me the way this guy came at me, where you're lying about me, and you're saying certain things, and that whole team did that, but obviously only he's the one that stepped up and is fighting me. But that whole team of that, you know, you got to come see me. At the end of the day, that's why people say, oh, why do you bother Connor? This and that. Bro, Connor promised you guys a full video 2 years ago. Why don't you guys bother Connor? I shouldn't need to bother Connor. I know what happened in this barn. But the fact that you guys keep talking about it and talking about it in a way where you guys haven't even seen the full shit, but you talk like you have, like, why don't you guys go bother the guy? You know what I mean? I shouldn't have to bother the guy. You know what I mean? But ultimately, like I said, once you've done that and you've lied and you've done that and you've put me in a bad light, you gotta come see me, bro, because it's a lie. You know what I mean? If it's the truth, I say, you know what? Oh, man, you know what? I got myself into that. I gotta live with it. I gotta earn it. But when it's a lie, cuz you gotta come see me, bro. Now it's a man-to-man thing. You know what I mean? So this guy's gonna come see me Saturday. We'll see you after that.
What would be your satisfaction in earning victory for this guy?
I don't know. Yeah, of course. You want to put a hurting on him. You want to see blood. You want to, you know, do all that. But, you know, and then just hear him talk. Hear him say the things he's saying about, like, how he wants to hurt me and he's going to punch holes in my head and he's talking about my parents and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? I come from a broken family as it is. It starts to irk you more. But, of course, he's already kind of reached the boiling point where I don't need any more motivation, you know. But of course, there's some of the things he says almost push you to the tipping point, right? That's why he's already been slapped and spit on before, you know. I didn't do that today out of kindness on my heart, because believe me, even when we were next to each other, he was sitting right there. I could have hit him with a backhand, and I thought about it, but I said, you know what? Let me let him live tonight. You know?
You're one of the best boxing analysts. Are you ready to go back to Showtime? Showtime has a lineup stacked with fights.
Yeah, I'm excited. Ready? I'm excited for next week, actually. Jamal Charlo's fighting Brandon Adams. Charlo, yeah.
Yes.
So I'm ready for that next week.
You do this for living, you break down fighters, so it was easy to break down Artem's tape if you did watch it.
I did. I couldn't watch a lot of it because he's getting looks that are not even close to the looks I give, so it's hard for me to gauge how he's gonna react to my looks and my punches and whatnot. I kind of get it. I've watched it a couple of times, but it's one of those things where you're like a fastball hitter and you're getting ready for a knuckleball pitcher, you know. And so you overthink it, you're gonna end up psyching yourself out. Artem is a guy who, when you watch him, looks like he can't fight for shit. He really, you know, and he's falling over himself and he's throwing haymakers and whatnot. But of course, the timing is so off that it could throw you off if you try to approach it in a complicated way. So you have to take a very simple approach. You also have to understand, as I watch him, he's not getting looks that I'm gonna give. He's not getting any. So I don't know what looks he's going to return to me based on the looks I get. And so, therefore, it could make anything I'm watching irrelevant because it could change the entire dynamic of the looks he gives me when we're fighting. Or he may not give me looks. He may just rush me, right? I mean, at the end of the day, I do think that he wants to get in the clinch and try to grab and hit me, hold and hit me, right? So he may not even give me any looks at all. So I got to be ready for a couple of different things. And that's how I broke him down. I got to be ready for a couple of different things.
Crossover fights, big fight in the news. Justin Bieber versus Tom Cruise. Who wins that fight?
Who?
Justin Bieber versus Tom Cruise.
Come on, man. I was taught to respect my elders. You know what I'm saying? So Conor McGregor is a piece of shit. He obviously wasn't taught that. So you don't even try to make that Bieber and Tom Cruise fight because Cruise is old enough to be like his grandfather. You know what I'm saying? Like, so you don't even talk about that fight. That's ridiculous.
Does Tom have enough in the tank to beat the Biebs?
you're not going to give up on this one. No.
Who wins? It's a legit fight.
All right. Youth beats age.
You got Bieber.
I got Bieber, yeah. But I don't want to see them fight.
Hey, Paulie, this is your show. This is your show. How do you feel being the main event? The main event, the man, the
well, this everybody. Is one of the main reasons too. You know what I mean? It's, obviously, I don't like Artem, but this was the thing where I said, when it was offered to me, I said, in boxing, I'll have to build back to this, and I probably don't have the ability anymore in boxing at a world-class level to build back to this level. You know, but you told me, trust me, right into this, and I'm at this level right away. You know, in a fight that's very winnable, I said. And I guess a guy I don't like. So, well, I know, it's motivation. And then the money was good. So I'm like, motivation. I think I got enough motivation to do this. And then when we started going, I was like actually looking forward to getting up in the morning. I was going to sleep early. Bro, I don't go to sleep at night sometimes, bro. You know what I mean? I like to go out. I like to hang out. I like to just chill and talk, whatever. Like, I'm like a night owl. You know, like I was wanting to go to sleep at night because I wanted to train good the next day. You know what I mean? Like, it changed my perspective, at least for a training camp. But I didn't know if I had that mentality in me yet still. And I did. And I not only did I, but I didn't mind it either. You know, and so it's been good. And that's one of the reasons was because, like you said, this is my show.
Yeah, it's all your show. Any predictions on upcoming fights if the Spence and Porter fight do happen?
It's hard to pick against Spence at welterweight right now. I pick Spence against every welterweight there is right now. You know, he's a tough one to pick against.
Wilder Fury too?
Oh, man. Hopefully we see it. You know, we got Wilder and Ortiz in September. Hopefully we get a Wilder Fury as well. Yo, Fury looked good the other day. Pacquiao Thurman's a good fight because, you know, Keith looked like he was shaking off some rust in the Jose Zito Lopez fight. And Pacquiao looked good against Broner. It's kind of a good fight. I feel like he's going to bring a little bit more to the table now that he shook off the rust. But then, of course, you got to bring more to the table to fight, to beat the Pacquiao, to beat Broner. So I think it's an evenly matched fight. It's a good fight.
And the big one, Ruiz, Anthony Joshua, too.
Oh, man. I don't know. Let's see where it winds up first. That's an interesting one. You know, I don't want to make excuses for Joshua, and I want to give tons of credit to Ruiz because he did the thing, and he approached the fight with a lot of character, a ton of character. But I don't know, Joshua just looked like he didn't want it there, man. I feel like Ruiz psyched him out during the week. I feel like Ruiz played the nice guy role during the week and just psyched him out because I remember when Joshua fought Vladimir Klitschko, a fight that I also worked ringside, and he was just a ball of fire. You know what I mean? He was like, he went down and he didn't care. He got up and he was ready to pounce regardless. You know, he was ready. Like, he was ready in case a negative thing happened in that fight. I feel like in the Ruiz fight, all the good guy role, it suckered Joshua into believing that this was going to be an easy fight. And when you believe it's going to be an easy fight, you are not prepared mentally when it going gets tough. You now have to kind of reassess your mind. And in the moment, it's hard to do that. So I do think that Joshua, I wouldn't say intentionally took him lightly, but I think because you got to give Ruiz credit for playing the nice guy role. I think Ruiz suckered him, and I don't think you get suckered in the second fight. But it's still, nonetheless, Ruiz is a better fighter than people realize, and I'm glad people now saw that, and I think it's gonna be a good fight. But yo, while we're on the subject, the fight I want to watch at heavyweight is Ruiz Konak. I want to watch Ruiz versus Konak.
Okay.
All right. That's a heavyweight bomb burner to the team, bro. Yeah. Ruiz versus Konak. The two fat guys who actually can fight. And they throw a ton of punches, and it's all action. That's a bang-out fight.
Ward at heavyweight.
Yeah. I hope we get to see that eventually.
Molly, are you taking... What do you think of Amir against Crawford? In your opinion, do you think he bowed out of the fight?
You know, it's hard to gauge because really, when a guy who's shown so much heart like Amir you get older, and like Artem said, sometimes you don't want it as bad, right? You get a little older. And I think Amir maybe doesn't have the same dig down as he used to. You know what I'm saying? So at that level, maybe he's got to get reassess himself and maybe diminish a level and then see if he can come back up. And that's what he's doing in his next fight. He's not fighting a Crawford level, but he's fighting a guy who, you know, we'll know where Amir is at. It's sort of a gauge even for Amir himself, you know, to see where he's at in this fight, you know, because this is the kind of opponent we would expect Amir to dismantle in his prime. We'll see how he handles this opponent on July 12th. And then from there, we'll see if the hunger's still there.
Are you taking Artem lightly?
Good question, right? I sound like I am, right? Yeah. No. No, 100%. Good observation. I'm not. Because I do think there's risk factors in this fight. And the risk factors are the unknown. You know, there is the unknown for myself. You know, there's the clinch and whatnot. And I know he's overplaying the whole clinch, because to get me in the clinch, you actually have to get to me. And so to close the gap on me is not that easy. And he knows that. Also, he's got two left feet, so closing the gap is even harder for a guy like that. He doesn't have the greatest footwork. But of course, do I not think about it? Of course I think about it. You know what I'm saying? So, but I don't think about it as much as he'd like me to think about it. But of course, it keeps me from taking a fight lightly, because there is the unknown there. You know what I'm saying? Also, when you ring the bell, you in a boxing match, you get to walk to center. You kind of get into your zone during that initial few steps you take the center ring. Right here, you may have to fight right off the jump, or you may have to take a step back off the jump. You know what I'm saying? So it depends. So of course there's reasons to not take anything lightly in this sport, especially when you haven't taken part in it, and I haven't taken part in it. So I've been fully focused and I'm fully addressing all the possibilities as well. No matter how much the trash talk I talk, it's not out of respect for Artem. For me, it's out of respect for the sport.
Well, you talked about motivation, that you found your motivation finally for this fight, but you were also kind of non-committal of whether you wanted to do it again. Yeah. Is that part of just to see how it feels afterwards?
Yeah,
to see maybe what comes out?
Well, because every fight has an individual motivation. And also, you know, I found a great motivation for this fight. There were several things motivated me for this fight. But of course, you know, you've got to find that motivation all over again for the next fight, you know? And I ideally could see myself doing it again, but I can't. I don't want to promise it and then suddenly I don't do it again, you know? Or I don't want to say I don't do it again and then I do it again, you know? So. You know, I take it, we'll see how Saturday feels. We'll see how it feels on Saturday. And then from there, you know, I'll probably still won't make a decision. I probably still will kind of take some chill time for the summer and then figure it out later.
Does Showtime have to okay me?
Showtime's always okay. I got
the shit. They have to okay. You have to get it, their permission to come fight it to...
I was an active fighter when I started working at Showtime. So I'm allowed to be an active fighter if I choose to be.
Do you
see this fight going a distance? We'll see. I mean, if it goes to distance, he's gonna get very bloody. He's gonna take a lot of shots. If it goes to distance, I'll give him credit.
Talking about unknowns, one of the unknowns, I feel like he keeps talking about your hands. That you don't have the hand durability. Can you talk about that? Do you think that's gonna be a factor, or it's something you don't know?
Yeah, I mean, I've had hand operations, but I haven't had one in 10 years. You know, last year, 11 years, my last hand operation. So my hands have been healthier the second part of my career. You know, but I also think Artem needs to hold on to certain things in order to give himself confidence. He's at the end of the day what you're dealing with here. This is a guy who's used to losing. Okay, he's used to losing, and then the psychology of losing becomes a part of you. You don't think twice about like the kind of tough opposition. Hey, yeah, if we lose, we lose. We just fight because we lose. We're used to losing already, right? That's somebody like him. That's how the subtle psychology starts to take place. So for Artem, he needs some also to give himself some subtle confidence. He needs to reach out for things like, oh, his hands have been hurt. You know, he doesn't have a lot of knockout power, even though with bare hands, I mean, come on, bro, every pro boxer and with bare hands is a puncher. And then, you know, he's trying to give himself confidence in any way possible, because, you know, he needs to. You know, he doesn't have, he's got a grasp for straws at the end of the day. And I think ultimately it's more of a knock on him than it is a knock on me. You know what I'm saying? I don't feel like we have to grasp for anything or over worry too much. Yes, we've had hand issues. Yes, there are issues in general with every fighter at certain points or another, right? I mean, that's just what happens. But you don't really think about that. You know, like I always try to think about my opponent. He's going to bring the best version of him possible, you know, on Saturday night or whatever night I'm fighting, you know? Regardless of how much trash talk, I think if I approach it that way, I can't take my opponent lightly. You know what I'm saying? So Saturday night, whatever the best version of Artem is, I feel like he's gonna bring it. I don't think there's a best version. I think there's a tough version. You know, like I think Artem will be extra motivated and be tough on Saturday night. But I don't think he's gonna suddenly pop up with skills that he hadn't shown us before. You know, but of course, like we talked about before, there is the unknown that you try to prepare for and you get yourself ready. But he's grasping for straws. At the end of the day, he's grasping for straws because ultimately, when you've lost like this constantly and repetitively in your career, you know who's gonna whoop your ass. And Saturday night, he knows he's gonna get his ass whooped Saturday night. He's just talking a good game because he wants to sell pay per views so he can make his biggest purse yet.
Paulie, touching on the hand issue, I know a lot of MMA fans feel it's gonna be a big factor in the fight. You put your piece on it, but do you think they're overlooking the amateur experience you have, the world championship experience you've had at a different level in terms of striking coming into this fight?
I'll be honest with you. If they're MMA fans, the only thing they know about me is what Conor and Artem have talked. Artem has talked a bunch of bullshit. So you know, if they don't actually watch boxing or follow boxing or actually watch my fights or follow my career, the conclusions they come to are really just lying to themselves. And they're gonna make the bookies a lot of money this weekend. You know what I mean? Because you know, I'm sure that plus money on Artem Lobov looks really tempting to them if they think that I'm that limited. You know, so a big winner this weekend is gonna be the bookies too. You know, if that's really the case. But I don't really worry about who's underestimating me or not, because ultimately, praise doesn't win you fights and criticism doesn't win you fights. You or yourself, your fists, your brains, they win you fights.
Any pressure, you're representing the whole boxing community, and they put it as MMA versus boxing. You're representing boxing all the way. He's representing mixed martial arts. Any pressure if you were to, something was to happen, something crazy versus you versus Artem?
I don't feel pressure because I think people have made it boxing versus MMA. I have a lot of friends who are MMA fighters. I have a lot of friends who are obviously boxers. You know, I come from boxing and I always give my love to boxing. But of course, I also have a lot of friends who are MMA fighters as well. So good MMA fighters. So if I put it as an MMA versus boxing thing, it would kind of be disrespecting my friends on that side too. So I don't really make it at that. It's more of a personal situation, but it's very, very personal. You know, like when you disguise it as Paulie spit and Paulie slap, and that's very disrespectful. You're taking it completely out of context. Right. You know, there's a reason he's getting spit on and smacked, and there's a reason he would get it even worse if I could have. You know what I'm saying? And the reason Saturday's gonna get it worse. You know, it's a personal issue, and when you don't take it out of context, I would assume it's understandable.
Thank you for your time, man.
Thank you. After all this time in the MMA world, a little bit, like, what do you think of the MMA fan base after all this time?
It's a weird culture. Yeah, I don't know. It's a weird culture. They remind me of wrestling fans, except that they're in a combat sport that's real. It's not staged, you know. But they remind me of wrestling fans, you know. They're very cartoonish, very out there, you know. And again, I blame it on what I said last month. I blame it on MMA fighters don't die, because when your fighters die, your fan base has a bit of a more smart thinking the way they talk. MMA fans talk the way the fighters talk about kill this guy and do this and fighting bears and whatever the hell else that you guys talk about. But ultimately, you know, you're going to see your fighter in a couple of months, and you're going to see your fighter in the next week attending another fight. In boxing, you don't have that promise. In boxing, our favorite fighters get killed sometimes or wind up in coma sometimes. So I think there's a reason why the boxing fan is more domesticated and the MMA fan is more rough around the edges. But it's fine. It's a different culture. But the difference with wrestling and MMA is wrestling's there's a contract already out there with a result already stipulated, and there's a script. MMA fights are not stipulated and scripted. But like I said, guys at least are coming out safe and sound. And that's a positive.
Thank you, Paulie.